كتاب الله دستوري وخير الخلق أسوتنا بسنته.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Ramadan Mubarak, Ramadan Kareem, my ikhwah, my brothers. I just wanted to share a very short reminder regarding the month of Ramadan and the purpose behind it. Hopefully, and I pray that this benefits those who are unaware of it and it benefits those who are just reminded. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَذَكِّرْ فَإِنَّ الذِّكْرَ تَنْفَعُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. So remind, for indeed the reminder benefits the believers. Now the purpose of fasting, why do we fast? We go straight into the Quran. Allah says, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, O you who believe. And whenever Allah says, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, O you who believe, He is speaking to a specific group, meaning the believers, meaning the Muslims. And this is why the ulama have said that when Allah is using this sort of term, instead of Ya ayyuha alnas, when He says, O mankind, Ya, O you who believe, He is speaking to the closest people to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the closest people to Tawheed, La ilaha illallah. So he's referring to us and he wants us to pay extra attention to these verses. So when we hear these verses, whenever Allah says, Ya ayyuhallazina amanu, we need to get up a little bit more. If we're crouched, if we're lying, and we should pay extra attention to these verses. So Allah says after saying, Ya ayyuhallazina amanu, كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. Fasting has been prescribed to you as it was prescribed to those before you. Why? لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ, that you may attain taqwa. And the very reason, purpose of fasting, the aim of fasting is to attain taqwa. The word taqwa cannot just literally be translated into the English where English language say it means God consciousness, it means God fearing. It means those two, it means more. Linguistically, it also comes from the word which means a shield. Shield from what? Shield from in the disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So it's very important we understand the meaning of taqwa, and then we try to attain taqwa. If we fail to attain taqwa in the month of Ramadan, then our whole purpose of fasting during the month of Ramadan has been a failure. And this is a massive failure, because all the fasting, all the charity work, all the Quran recitation, the adhkar, and the good treatment towards your parents, neighbors, and so on and so forth will be null. So what do? We go into the Quran and understand what the word taqwa means. Right in the beginning, in the Quran, you will find Allah says, Alif Lam Mim, ذلك الكتاب لا ريب فيه هدى للمتقين. Alif Lam Mim, this is a book wherein there is no doubt, a guidance for the mankind, هدى للمتقين, sorry, a guidance for those who have got taqwa. Now different parts of the Quran have used the taqwa in different forms, in various forms. So it's really vital to understand the taqwa. I will go into a very short explanation from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and also from the Sahaba. The Prophet once told his companions, and two of the beautiful companions, illustrious companions, famous companions, by the name of Abu Dhal Ghifari radiallahu anhu and Mu'adh ibn Jabal radiallahu anhu, both narrated this hadith together. They said, they heard the Prophet say, اتَّقِ اللَّهَ حَيْثُمَا كُنْتْ, fear Allah wherever you are. So the word taqwa is used here. اتَّقِ اللَّهَ حَيْثُمَا كُنْتْ, fear Allah wherever you are. وَأَتْبِعِ سَيْئَةَ الْحَسَنَةَ, and follow up a bad deed with a good deed. تَمْحُوهَا, it will wipe it away. وَخَالِقُ النَّاسَ بِخُلِقٍ حَسَنٍ, and be good towards the creation. So right in the beginning of this hadith, the Prophet has used the word taqwa. Here you can clearly see what the Prophet is referring to. He's saying, wherever you are, whether in your privacy or public areas, you be aware of Allah, Allah's power, Allah's knowledge, Allah's omniscience, Allah's presence, Allah's wrath befalls upon those who disobey Him, Allah's pleasure befalls on those who do good deeds. And finally, a short explanation from the Sahaba. A companion asked another companion, what is taqwa? The other companion said, have you ever walked on a path when on either side of your path it was narrow and there were thorny bushes on either side? He said, yes. He said, what did you do? He said, I grabbed my garment, I picked it up and treaded carefully until I ended. I went to the other side. He said, that is taqwa, being careful in life, treading carefully. What we speak, what we utter, what we hear, what we smell, what we see, what we do, everything is going to be it has to be in accordance to Allah's pleasure. Alhamdulillah, the blessed month of Ramadan, everyone enjoins the good and forbids the evil. Even those who drink alcohol, they stop drinking alcohol. Even those who have relations in the haram way, they stop relations in the haram way. And even those who smoke, they stop smoking, alhamdulillah. So all these things are actually what? Having a fear of Allah, because you would not fast and at the same time smoke. There is no way a person would smoke and fast. He would not deliberately fast. Likewise, a person would not drink alcohol and fast. Likewise, a person would not really have relations and then fast at the same time. So what this means is it gives us a platform. Ramadan gives us a platform to build this taqwa, to build this discipline in our lives. And inshallah, it will give us taqwa. And inshallah, it will give us victory in this world. And inshallah, it will give us admission into paradise. Jazakumullah khairan. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.
أحب الوفي الأمين الأغر فأهل الوفاء كلون السر.